It is astonishing to me, and you look at Hillary Clinton's numbers, and they're pretty strong too. You know, who would have thought during the 2008 election, when she lost that nomination, that we would hear, we would see the kind of numbers of support that we're seeing for her as well in all of this. Now, I want to get to the other big political dynastic family of our generation, which is the Bushes. Very interesting piece this morning in which Simon Rosenberg, there's a number of very influential Democratic strategists who are quoted in this piece, and here's the basic gist of what they're saying. Simon Rosenberg says that President Obama, he believes in 2012, is going to have a tough time holding North Carolina and Virginia. He says the Midwest is going to be suffering from this auto decline, so that puts Ohio, Michigan, Indiana, and Wisconsin on wobbly territory for President Obama. So he says the firewall for this president has to be that Latino belt, as he describes it, from Florida to Southern California, and he says the only Republican who can give Obama a run for his money in that belt is Jeb Bush. Brad? You know, Jeb Bush has always said that he would never run, and yet we're seeing him speaking out and just participating a fair amount lately.
A lot of good Republicans, a lot of good Democrats always say it's not for them until all of a sudden there's a groundswell of support, money starts coming in, and their opinions change. Jeb Bush is certainly an attractive candidate. I think he was the only governor who was reelected to that spot. Twice a Republican for an important electoral state like Florida. Great record, left as popular as when he came in. Certainly a great draw amongst Republicans from east to west, north and south. So let's look where Jeb goes. Let's look at how much money he's able to raise for Republicans and get those important political chips. And that'll give you a good indication of where he is for 2012.
And they put, I mean, his wife is of Latino background. He's a fluent Spanish speaker. Doug, and so that raises the big question. Bush fatigue. Can Jeb Bush successfully overcome that?
Well, there are two answers to that question. First, we have to see in the fall campaign the degree to which the record of the Bush administration is pitted against the Obama administration successfully by the Democrats. If that happens, that's a cautionary flag. But the second is, will there be an alternative Republican slash Jeb Bush agenda that is forward-looking and proactive? Because it's not going to be the same policies warmed over. There's got to be a new agenda. And if the former governor of the state of Florida articulates such an agenda, along with his colleagues in the Senate and the House on the Republican side, then maybe, just maybe, there will be another Bush.
Bush and Clinton. Here we are, still talking about those names in a very relevant political conversation today. Really. Brad Blakeman, thank you very much. Doug Schoen, always good to see you guys. You have a great
weekend. Thank you.
We'll see you soon. And I'd like to hear from you and get your thoughts on this. Go to America's Newsroom homepage and foxnews.com/America's Newsroom. Send me an email. You can click on the link that says Martha@foxnews.com, or you can send me a tweet at Martha McCallum. And we'd like to hear what you think about that, about Jeb Bush and about the possibility of the reemergence of the Bush and Clinton names in politics. Very interesting.
Been with us for 20 years, right?
They sure have.
Bill from Ohio writes this.
Come on, Halston.
No, I'll get back to it. House Democrats were up in arms. We know that, lashing out at the White House. Democrat Wasserman Schultz is live here on That in Moments. Have things cooled down? And Lindsay Lohan has found a new home. Will rehab keep her out of jail?
I tried to make me go to rehab. I said no.
So if I switch to Progressive, I could save hundreds.
Yep, but that's just the start. We have a great loyalty program.
I'm listening.
Stick with us and you keep earning bigger discounts and benefits like accident forgiveness. Plus, it's free.
Wow, great.
Now let's get you initiated into the program.
What is that?
Watch. Here you go. Automatically enrolled. Painless, right?
Totally painless.
Rewarding loyalty. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
Trying to keep your monthly bills and papers organized can really get you stressed, because there's no good way to keep your files and papers from becoming a cluttered mess. Well, now there's Wonderfile, the ingenious organizer that turns any space into a neatly organized workplace. The clear four-corner filing system makes it easy to organize important documents, or you can see them and find them with ease. The large center pocket stores your files, pads, and folders. Even a laptop computer fits right in. The smooth writing cleaning surface lets you get paperwork done neatly and quickly. And the zippered pocket protects all your important documents.